If, as a result of his presidency, the world does indeed end, won't it be marvellous to think it happened in our time?
He might change what the word presidential means. Like, in a few years, yeah, you'll be going, oh, my uncle fell over and banged his head on a curb. He's been rendered completely presidential.
He dismissed the head of the FBI this week.
Coney, James Coney?
Mr. Comey was dismissed.
Comey over.
Because he was...
investigating his connections with Russia.
And now there's an inquiry. Who's been put in charge of the inquiry?
They've got a special prosecutor.
A former... Yeah. Yeah, head of the FBI.
And when you open up that special prosecutor, there'll be another little special prosecutor. You open up, there'll be another. And eventually, a little bloke saying, "Did you do it?"
Robert Mueller.
He's Robert Mueller, who was the former FBI director. James Comey's done something to get his revenge on Trump.
Any idea he has what produced his memo.
Oh,
he kept a memorandum.
Yes.
After Trump tweeted that he had kept, or suggested he might have kept, a recording of the dinner that took place in February. Comey then came back to say, well, I kept a memorandum.
And he said, will you drop the Russian stuff? So basically he accused him of literally trying to interfere in the process of justice. And the Americans don't like that very much. So it is all going wrong.
Yeah.
And then the best bit was Putin, who was like, oh, if you want the transcript, we've got one.
How did Trump's administration respond to Comey's leak?
With confusion.
With incredible confusion. According to online news website Daily Beasts, one official said, I felt like running down the hallway with a fire extinguisher.
His basic problem is he's confusing the role of President of America with 1970s light entertainment comedian at the BBC. And the fact that everyone's tolerated him up to this moment, suddenly they've said, well, look, Donald Trump, he's awful. How could we have told? And he's been campaigning for months and months, and we've never had any indication that he might be thoroughly ghastly in any number of ways. I mean, how are we to know? This is unfair.
At what point was it not ludicrous that the presenter of The Apprentice in America could become the Commander-in-Chief? It's like saying the presenter of Have I Got News For You could become Foreign Secretary. Mm.
I'm sure that loyalty will be rewarded.
I've never watched an election unfold over a U.S. election unfold overnight from London, from watching the BBC overnight. And that's the way. If you want to watch America go down the dumper, watch it through the befuddled nocturnal fog of a man named Andrew Neil. Watch him. A man who's just barely on top of everything. And he just sits there, and he had other people beside him. He looks like he's squeezed in like this. And then when they're not there, he still looks like he's squeezed in. Like his body's trying to eject itself. And he comes out, and he's trying to explain the Electoral College, and he doesn't quite, nobody quite gets it, because it's impossible to explain, and it just, somebody's got to get a 270. Somebody, and now you're watching a scoreboard at a bowling alley, and then finally they give up, and they just bring out this guy who just dances on a map. He just dances on a map, and he's trying to show all the states with his feet. He's going like, oh, there's Wisconsin, and there's Ohio, and oh, there's a red state turning blue. Oh, oh, I mean, Christ. Trump is becoming president, and the guy's playing Twister. And then finally, you know, there's just at the top of Andrew Neil's head, spray-on thatch thing. And comes back up at 6:30 and says, oh, Trump's president, and great, Trump's president, I'm watching an acorn talk to me.
The longest TV review I've ever heard.
When he says stuff, it doesn't have to be practical, it doesn't have to be true, because he's a liar. He's a liar and he's a racist. He's a friend of Piers Morgan's. There's...
No, come on,
Piers Morgan said he was.
No, Andy, no, Piers has got no friends, you know.
Let's look at how his ban would work in practice. It's quite simple, actually. Trump explained what border guards would say when faced with travellers trying to enter the country. They would say, are you Muslim? And if the answer is yes, they wouldn't be allowed into the country. So it's a very workable way of doing it. So I think in answer to your question, who would be allowed into the country under his system, it's anyone.
He's getting the backwash now. Even from places like Dubai, where lots of investments, they don't want his name attached to it, they're pulling out. They're not actually... you know, Trump trinkets sold big in the Middle East. Trump toothpaste, Trump toothbrushes.
Trump really?
Hair. Yeah.
Trump toothbrushes.
Well, I'm making Trump toothbrushes.
All right, because you wouldn't want anything to do with him in your mouth. And how did Britain first get involved in Trump's recent remarks?
He said that London was...
no-go areas.
London was a no-go
police
area.
For certain you police can't... officers.
Yes, he said...
There are certain places in London police are officers. Scared for their lives. Yeah. Sports Direct.
Yeah.
Going there.
yes, he bolstered.
Are you one of their regular customers?
Yeah. It's where I get my trainers.
But they still do the ones with the buckles.
They do.
Landmark moment in Trump's presidency did the trip signify?
He was about to be impeached. so he thought if he went abroad, he could make more of a fool of himself than at home. I mean, it is extraordinary. He said about the Saudis that they threw people off buildings and had an appalling attitude to women during the campaign. Then he got there and said, this is a magnificent kingdom. I mean, he contradicts himself almost mid-sentence nowadays. He can't keep it up. Yeah. And he criticised Obama for bowing to the Saudis. Yeah, and then he himself curtsied. Look, he does this sort of weird thing and then puts on the... Award of the great flogger of the Temple of Doom or whatever it is.
that was an ITV quiz show that never got past the pilot.
It is quite extraordinary. Mm. And having failed to point out that, you know, if you're going to Saudi Arabia to make a speech about where this appalling version of Islam comes from that preaches terrorism and extremism, where is it? Oh, it's here. Not a mention of it.
They were told at the official dinner he needed to have ketchup on standby. Do you want to know a fascinating fact about tomato ketchup?
Yes.
Yes.
I'm going to say that one again.
Yeah.
Do you want to know a fascinating fact about tomato ketchup?
Oh, yes. Yeah.
Henning's auditioning for the Churchill dog ads.
Well, as some of Brexit looming, I'm a lot more amenable to advertising.
What was Donald Trump's latest contribution to the health of Americans? He mused aloud whether it would be a good idea for people to inject disinfectant into themselves or to perhaps even drink it to clean out their lungs. I think he should be the first to volunteer. He later claimed that he was being sarcastic. There was a marvellous bit when he said, no, I was being sarcastic, I was talking to the reporters, and in fact, I was looking straight at you, he said to a reporter. I was looking straight at you when I said this, and the reporter said, I wasn't there.
I was just going to say, we ran a piece in Private Eye 3 weeks ago, which was meant to be a joke, saying that because bleach is very effective against the virus, perhaps you should put your head over a bowl of it and inhale it. And I just had no idea he was a subscriber.
Well, that just is a gratuitous advert for Private Eye. Why isn't they being allowed to come on and gratuitously publicise Private Eye?
Well, as Paul says, he's got some very interesting ideas on how we might treat coronavirus that the experts might not have thought of.
Supposing we hit the body with a tremendous, whether it's ultraviolet or just very powerful light. And I think you said that hasn't been checked, but you're going to test it. And then I said, supposing you brought the light inside the body, which you can do either through the skin or in some other way. Right. And then I see the disinfectant where it knocks it out in a minute, 1 minute. And is there a way we can do something like that by injection inside or...
Oh, she just looks like every woman who sat at the bus stop minding their own business and the weird, crazy guy just doesn't leave them alone. Like, her logic is just stare at the ground for long enough and maybe he'll go away.
I can think of a good way of getting light into his body. I'd shove an angle-poised lamp right up the Oval Office.
She's not completely blameless either, because she's given interviews in which she said that Donald Trump's business past, which involves various bankrupt casinos, has given him skills and insights that really help him understand the science in this case.
Here he is saying goodbye to the first person to try injecting themselves with disinfectant.
We'll do it.
If you can remember back that far, this is the return to work of Boris Johnson on Monday. There's speculation as to how Boris's new son might affect his thinking on government policy. Well, if my experience of dealing with new babies is anything to go by, it'll be wanting to reopen the pubs within about 2 days. Speaker of the House, Sir Lindsay Hoyle, welcomed the news and said for Carrie and Boris, 2020 is certainly a year they will never forget. Although, hopefully, with enough therapy, the rest of us might.
For round two, fingers on buzzers, teams, as for the first time tonight, we go over to Peter Snow and the swingometer of news.
David, thank you. What I can definitely say is that it's turning into a very bad night for Ian. Even at this early stage, you can see this dramatic swing to this rather fascinating curio.
So, yeah, there's a new book come out which indicates that Donald Trump cheats at golf like he does at everything else. He's got caddies that he's specifically trained to sort of lie for him. He's got balls hidden all around. He once claimed to win a golf tournament while he was playing at another golf tournament 87 miles away. He has no shame gene, so it doesn't matter to him. He doesn't think, oh, you know, how pathetic that I should be cheating at golf. He thinks that as long as he's won, that's all that matters.
If that's his only flaw.
Do you know who the sports journalist was?
Yes, somebody Riley.
Rick Riley.
Rick Riley.
Do you know what the book was called?
Everything you need to know about Trump you can learn from how he plays golf, something like that.
Commander in Cheat.
Commander in Cheat, that's it, yes. How Golf Explains Trump,
that's
yes.
That's right. And do you know what Riley said about Trump in particular?
Well, he's notorious for lying about his scores and...
Cheats like a mafia accountant.
Yes. He does walk around like a mafia don, doesn't he? Yeah. The overcoat and stuff, yeah. You know.
What did Trump say to a golfer who was foolish enough to beat him at golf? He said, it's all right, I've got a supermodel girlfriend and my own Boeing 7. One of his golf courses in Florida has a plaque on the wall saying he was the 1999 championship winner. Mm. Why is that a problem?
Well, because he didn't play that championship. Is this the one where he was playing 87 miles away?
That's because the golf course wasn't open in 19...
Oh, it wasn't open.
Who's been caught lying this week in a possible attempt to get closer to Trump?
The Attorney General? Is it somebody from this side of the Atlantic?
Give you a hint, it's a Chinese woman.
Oh, yes, the lady that went into that, whatever that resort is called that he owns, she went in there with all sorts of software and tried to log onto the internet or something and steal all sort of sensitive data.
That's correct. Yeah. According to the BBC, she told staff she was there to use the swimming pool, but the Secret Service agent called Samuel Ivanovich noticed that she was carrying four mobile phones, a laptop, an external hard drive and a thumb drive with a computer virus on it, but no swimsuit. Other than the truth, what else has Trump been struggling to say this week?
Oh, he can't say the word origins.
Let's just have a look.
No collusion, no obstruction. I hope they now go and take a look at the oranges of the investigation, the beginnings of that investigation. You look at the origin of the investigation.
Comes out as oranges.
Talking about his suntan.
Yes, indeed, yes. And maybe the colour of the suit he'll be wearing in a couple of years' time.
A new book has confirmed that Donald Trump cheats at golf and doesn't like losing. According to the author of the new book about Donald Trump's golfing habits, the president doesn't just cheat, he fudges and foozles and fluffs. And once he's sorted his hair out, he plays golf. Following the completion of the Mueller report, the Kremlin spokesman Dmitry Peskov mocked suggestions that Russia had colluded in the US elections. It's hard to find a black cat in a dark room, especially if it's not there. Although, as Donald Trump himself boasted, if anyone in a dark room can grab pussy, it's him.